it is so important for us to take this message of the blood of Jesus to the last corner of the whole world. They must know about Jesus. They must know that he died on the cross 2,000 years ago. He shed his blood so that they could be forgiven. And so that
let this man
be in him, which was in Christ Jesus. The mind of Christ was the mind to obey God, to give your life. Have a mind to give your life to God. It's a privilege. It's a privilege. To be saved is a privilege. To work for God is a privilege. To do anything for God is a privilege. This is the way Jesus Christ. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody, no one on this earth can come to the Father except his son. If it is true, if this thing is true, I said, if it is true, and it is true. So I'm talking about, what's my topic? Mysterious wisdom. Or, the verse 7, the wisdom of God in a mystery. The wisdom of God in a mystery. A mystery. A mystery. It's mysterious. This is the wisdom that God wants you to have. And you are going to be wise from today. Many things fall into this category. And many people are not able to tap into it. Sometimes I watch people. You know, if you look at people who have prospered today, like really, really prospered, it's not from school. Look at the footballers. No matter how many degrees you do, you are never going to have the money that ACN or Asamoajan has. Who cannot speak English properly? Huh? Because I want to share with you the mystery of wealth. Yeah. Oh, I wonder if you have the time. Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45. Verse 1. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden to subdue the nations. Before him I will loose the loins of kings and open before him the two-leaved gates. All gates that have been closed to you will be opened from today. And the gate shall not be shut. I will go before thee and make the crooked place straight. I will break in pieces the gates of brass and cut in sunder the bars of iron. Verse 3. I will give to my anointed treasures, the treasures of darkness and the hidden riches of secret places. Huh? Is this what he's going to give to his anointed? It's mysterious. But look at it. All treasures are in darkness. Gold is under the ground. It's in the dark place. Huh? Yeah. All the oil is under the sea. Dark! There's no light there. There may be oil under here, right where I'm walking. Treasures of darkness. And then the hidden riches of secret places. Most riches have been hidden. Most Ghanaians who have prospered have hidden their riches. And they didn't hide it in the open. They've hidden it in secret places. Yes. Recently, they were unfolding some of the secret places.
there's a country which keeps all the secret monies. And they said, we are going to, they force a law to open those secrets. Yes. So that all those who have money here, you are escaping, you are not paying tax. That's why your money is here. So they brought some laws to bring them out. Hey! Hidden riches of secret places. Even in your house, the small money that you have, you have hidden it in a secret place. Is it not true? Hidden riches of secret place. So all money is found in these places. Darkness, and it's hidden, and it is in a secret place. And it's not going to be that easy for you to access that money. Oh yeah. It's hidden. Just coming along and saying, I've gone to school, I've got my degree, I'm going to get all the money of secret places. You think the secret places are just going to give out the money? Every secret place is heavily guarded. Hey, even when you get it, you see, when you get there, you will not know where the secret is. Yeah. If you even see the thing, you see that I don't know where it is. So money is like that. That is why people go to school, are going to America. Don't you know some people who've gone to America? Why have they not been visiting? Have you ever wondered why they don't come back? Have you wondered why they don't send you thousands of dollars? Have you wondered why sometimes somebody who is living in Ghana will be looking after his mother or his father more than the one who's gone to America? At least that is what I know. That's what I see. It's a mystery. It's mysterious. Why? Because the money in America is not open for people to collect. It is also treasure of darkness and hidden riches in secret places. So you also need the wisdom of God that can make you move ahead. Yeah, naturally going the way you are going is not going to be. Marriage, it takes hidden wisdom. Oh yeah. It's not about just doing your hair. It's not about just showing some parts of your body. Even to stay married, happy, or to be happy in marriage, if you don't, it's God who made it. And the wisdom to be married and to stay married is hidden also. If you just go by your natural thing. And when you say, I will say, I will not stand for whatever. How much did you get in school? You had 67%. I had 83. What did you do in this? What's your father? Who is your mother? What do I have? What do you have? What did you bring to the marriage? What do I have? What do you have? When I say this, you say that. What is that? But I may be older than you because some are older than us. So I'm even older. You have to be careful. My father has never done this before. My mother did like that. You see, you cannot use your natural that on human means a human right for this, this, and that. Your husband can rape you. Now they say you can rape if you sleep with a wife. It can be rape. It's part of the laws they are bringing. You know? It's not like that. Things are hidden. So you can be near money. You will never taste it. Yeah. Yeah. You can be near big money. You will never. But because it is hidden. It is in secret places. Just small has been brought out. The treasures are in darkness. Today God is going to give you the key. The key. You see, when you meet somebody who has a secret, you realize that he's the right person. He has a secret of something. And because of the secret that he has, he must qualify. He is the right person to have the riches. Hey, are you still around? Turn with me to Nina. Genesis. You remember the story of Genesis. Remember the story of Joseph. Remember the story of Joseph. Yeah. Let's read 41 verse 32. Now therefore, Pharaoh, so verse 32, the dream was doubled unto Pharaoh twice. Okay? It is because the thing is established by God and God will shortly bring it to pass. Now therefore, Pharaoh, look out a discreet and wise man and set him over the land of Egypt. Okay? Are you with me?
Yes.
Make him a prime minister. Make him the boss. Give him the top job. Make him the richest man. How many want that job? You are the next person to be made. That way. He said, let Pharaoh do this and let him appoint him officers over the land and take up the fifth part of the land in the seven plenteous years. And let them gather the food of those good years that come and lay up corn. He's giving the strategy, the wisdom. Let them keep food in the cities. He's telling how to be done. The next one, verse 36. And the food shall be a store to the land against the 7 years of famine which shall be in the land of Egypt, that the land perish not through the famine. Verse 37. And the thing was good in the eyes of Pharaoh and in the eyes of all his servants. The next verse. And Pharaoh said unto his servants. Pharaoh said to him, it will be said of you. Can we find such a one as this, in whom the Spirit of God is? Wow. And notice the next verse. Pharaoh gave Joseph the reason for his appointment. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, for as much as God has showed thee all this, God has shown all these things to you. God has shown you his will. God has shown you his word. There is none so discreet and wise. You have had a revelation. You have a revelation. You have the revelation. God has showed you. God has showed you. God has showed you. God has shown you. Now, verse 39. Verse 39. There is no one discreet. God has shown you. Verse 40. Take over. Take over. Take over Egypt. Take over everything. Take over. Take over. You are now in charge. Take over. I don't want to even bother. Take over the whole country. Yeah, take over the whole country. Police commander, minister of interior, take over. Just take over. I know you are in prison this morning. I say take over. Why? Because God has shown you something. Hey! You see, a person who has received a revelation of wisdom. You see, I know the revelation that God gave me, wisdom to prosper. That's how come I prospered. It's through that particular key. I keep sharing with people, but they don't believe it. It's hidden, it's hidden, it's hidden, it's hidden. I told you it's hidden. When I share, they just don't understand what I'm saying. Yeah. All that people have gone to search for, God has sent it to me. Oh, it's true. I can't lie to you. Sent, brought it. And you see, you can't find, let's say, some human wisdom to explain. Okay, number one, networking. Number two, keep to your old friends. Number three, what? Work hard. Work 12 hours a day. 8 hours for survival. 12 hours a day for prosperity. Then number five, work weekends. Number six, have smart goals. S stands for what? Sustainable, manageable, attainable, reachable, reliable. T for time related. It's not. I'm not talking about that. That's what God. I never heard of such things. I never heard of such things. God showed me something. He says, go back to verse 39. I like verse 39. The verse 39 is a fantastic verse. He said that Pharaoh said he gave him the reason for his appointment. He said, for as much as God has showed thee all these things. That's why I say to you, listen to the word. Have a revelation in the word. For as much as God has showed thee all these things. Then verse 40 is what? Take over. take over the country. Take over. You are not the commander. You are not the president. You are not in charge. Take over. None of us will be a commander again. You will take over. Take over the whole. Take the whole country. Take it. Take all our food, everything. Take over. And it's true. Because when his brothers came, he just put them, they were his brothers. He had taken over the country. Take over anointing. Ish. You see, that's why when the Bible says by wisdom a house is built, you will not really understand. It's, how can you build a house with wisdom? But it's true. A house is built by wisdom. How do I know? All these things about wisdom are true. Because you see, if you go to, if you give the Ghana government $5 billion, when you come back to Ghana in 2 years' time, do you see? They will not have built how Europe is. There will be no train. There will still be no road. There will be nothing. In South Africa, when you go to South Africa, you see South Africa is like America at the beginning of about 80 years ago, when the civil rights started. It's white and black mixed, but they don't mix at all. If you do something with a black man, a white man will never come. They have no interaction. They are free, but they have nothing to do with each other. When they were given power, they had so much billions, trillions. When Mbeki took over power, they had so many billion dollars in surplus. And their country is built. Power stations, anything you can, trains, light, water, any, it's like Europe, but black people are in villages, townships. Then these people came, the ones that are there. Now they owe, they are, after Mbeki, Mandela, Mbeki, then this one, now they have several trillions in debt. They've lost all the money. Like Ghana, you know, our currency was 1-1. One pound, one cedi. With a few railways and all that. But with all the money Ghana has had, all the cocoa we have had, all the forests that have been cut down, all the gold we have had, all the diamonds we have mined, all the aluminium that has gone to Valco, everything we have had, we never even needed Akosombo Dam. Because we had so much, we didn't need all that power. Everything has been used, but it's still, because I can give, if I give you $1 million, you cannot have Healing Jesus Crusade. If I give it to you, so have the crusade, here's the money. Because it's not by the money. If I give you $1 million, you cannot, when I come next time, you may not even have a house. Because you buy the hammer, which is whatever, you buy that cars, $100 and something, $1,000. Then you buy whatever, you travel abroad, you spend this, you do this. $1 million, to finish just now. Right now, you see that you are going to buy a house. When you go to buy the house, they say, oh, it costs this and that. You will see $1 million has been given to you, still not have anything. Because it's not by the money. That's what people don't realize. You see, when you travel around like I do, I see all the places where different wisdom has ruled. Depending on the wisdom that has ruled, you see what is there. Uh-huh. You see what we have there. It's fantastic. So you can give the same person a huge amount of money. It will not turn into anything. Yeah. It's amazing. And some of you, you know, if somebody was to have half as beautiful a face as you, half. Not full. Not to be as beautiful as you are, but half of your beauty. The person would marry like a hammer striking and they'll, bang, it's done. Half of your beauty, not your full. Let's say your beauty, you have, let's say, 92.6 units of beauty. And somebody is given 42 of that beauty, how your body is, how the curves are, how smooth your skin is, how your hair is, how beautiful you look. Somebody will give only 42%, 42 units of your beauty. You see the person will be like, bling! So the engagement is coming, a wedding is coming, this and this and this and this and that. Oh, yeah. And most fools, you give them wisdom. They'll do a karate on the wisdom just now. It'll go away. Half of your beauty. Half of your money. Have you ever heard of France, Switzerland, or Germany mining gold before? Have you ever heard of it in your darkest mind? Gold, coal, oil, this. Have you heard of anything like that before? They have nothing. That's why I said that if you give somebody half or 20 units of your 90 units that you have in Nigeria or Ghana of the oil. Nigeria is not the only country to find oil. America found oil, and America became the largest oil producer in the whole world. America, in Texas. They kept suspecting there was oil. They kept suspecting. They kept drilling in Texas. And one day they got a special strategy. And they hired some guys. And they said, go down, go down. They said, up to 100 meters, we pay you. If you don't find, they'll dig, dig, dig. I think 200 meters. And then one day we're at 180. Then suddenly, oil started to come out. That was how they found oil in Texas. It's not the only place. There are places which are given no oil. And no wisdom. Oh, and wisdom. Wisdom and no oil. Like Singapore. Singapore, when you stand here, you see the end of the country. You see down there is the sea. When you stand here, you see this is the sea. You see this is the sea. Small. You can walk across the whole day. When you walk one day, you get to the end of the country. If this was a Singaporean church and I'm to take an offering, I will get between $100,000 to $500,000 from this congregation here. That's how rich they are. Don't go shopping in Singapore. It's too expensive. Just visit. Tell your neighbor, I'll be visiting. Keep watching me. Tell your neighbor, everywhere my pastor is mentions, I will be there. If not for anything, for a visit. For my holidays, in Jesus' name. Oh, not a joke, but you are prophesying about your future. You shall have what you say. You shall have what you say. Amen. You can't believe it. You can't. You see, the strength of the group of people, you can tell from the offerings they give. When I go to different parts of Accra, different churches, Achimota, Abeka, Sakumono, Teshi, you see the offering different levels based on the area of Accra. And the countries is like that, like a place, just this group, at least $500,000 you get offering right now. Yeah. So wisdom, how many say mysterious wisdom? Eish. Now, you know, the wisdom that God has given me to prosper, I've prospered. Now, listen, the wisdom God has given me to prosper, he's given me a key. Do you understand when I say a key? Turn to Job 29, Job. Job. I love Job 29. It's a very nice chapter. If you don't know anything in Job, just go to 29, okay? There. Moreover, Job continued his parable, because not all the time Job is talking. The other guys, some of the things they say are not good. Oh, that I went as months passed, as in the days when God preserved me. Wow. You know, he was in trouble and he was saying, oh God, I wish it was the old days. When his candle shined upon my head, and when by his light I walked through darkness. What is his light? What is his light for your path? What is light for your path? And a lamp for your feet? The word. He said, oh, I wish I was in those days when his candle, his guidance, His guidance. I want to say something. It's not part of the sermon. But if it applies to you, don't even smile. And don't even say amen. Just write it down for yourself. Some of you girls, you have not got the wisdom that will make you marry. You need to hear your shepherd tell you, do this. And you say, yes, shepherd. That's the only way you will marry, not by your face. Yeah. It's not part of the message. But I'm telling you, your wisdom you have will not lead to marriage. It can't. It's only because of how your mind, you can know this wisdom only after you've been married for many years. And then you are transported back or you are reincarnated. And you come back as a young person with the wisdom you got after being married for 20 years. And you come back and restart. That's the only way you can get that wisdom. But it's, you know that it's not possible to go and come. Yeah. So the only way is to get a transposed wisdom from your shepherd. Yeah. But it's not part of the message. Just ignore it if you are. Hey, I wished when I was walking by his candle. May you walk by the candle of the Lord. When the Spirit of the Lord is leading you, the candle of the Lord. Wow. Look at it, verse 4. When I was in the days of my youth, those of you who think youth is for fooling around, youth is for serving God. Youth is for being holy. Youth is for following Jesus. He said, as I was in the days of my youth, when the secret of God was upon my tabernacle. When I was getting the secrets, I'm talking about secrets which change your life. That was a time when secrets were being revealed to me. I was tapping into secret. You see, that's what Pharaoh told Joseph. Said, since this has been shown to you, take over. And since you know the secret, take over. When Peter stood up and said, thou art the Son of God, Jesus said, take over, take over, take over the church. Flesh and blood has not revealed it to you. Have the church. Take over. You are in command. I see a taking over anointing coming over your life. When you get the secret of God, when the secrets and the hidden wisdom of God is revealed to you, suddenly you are the one who is put in charge. Like, be in charge, because it seems that it has been revealed to you. The secret has been given to you. Take over. Yes. Jesus said the same thing to Peter, fisherman said, take over. I'm the Son of God. It has been shown to you that I, born in a stable, am the Son of God. Today, it's been shown to you. Have it. Take over. You are in charge now. You are the boss now. It's all in your, I'll not think about it again. And Jesus never changed his command. Even when Peter denied him, he said, no. He's the one the thing was revealed to. May secrets of God be revealed to you. Yeah. He said, I wish I was when I was young and the secret of God was upon my tabernacle. The secret of God. The secret of God. The secret of God. The secret of God. The hidden wisdom of God. The wisdom of God in a mystery. The mysterious wisdom of God. Yeah. Which none of the princes of this world knew. If they had known, they would never have crucified the Son of God. It doesn't work that way with natural wisdom. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. When the Almighty was yet with me and my children were about me. Verse 6. When I washed my steps with butter. Ish, and the rock poured me out rivers of oil. I used to walk in the grace and the anointing. And the oil, rivers of oil were coming out of the rock. Supernatural oil. You see, oil that comes from a rock is supernatural. Yeah. My steps were washed with butter. Every step was an anointed step. Every step was an anointed step. Every step was an anointed step. The rocks were giving me rivers of oil. And I was walking. I wish I was like that when I was young. Those of you who think young means foolishness. Young means sex. Young means doing bad things. Young means do bad things and later say, I'm sorry. No, there are many people, I tell you, the secret of God is upon them on their tabernacle. When before I married, I remember telling my wife, my beloved at that time, I said, I have a dream. I will sit on a mountain and I'll preach to people and they'll come and listen to me like Jesus. That's my vision. That's what I want to do. When I was coming into the ministry, God gave me a little vision. Dream, vision, whatever. I was walking down a road like this, winding. I came to a heap. Some of you have heard me say it many times, and I keep saying it, but you see, you're not getting it. You're not getting it. And when I got there, it was gold. The heap of sand was a heap of gold coins. And I said, this is it. This is what? It. I've made it. And because when you take gold coins, it's just few. Cannot go in your hand. I wanted to make some calls and organize a tipper truck and some workers to come and load this whole, because it was no man's land. It was for whoever will find it. And I have found it. And suddenly the Lord spoke to me and said, no, no, no. No need. Take one handful. Just one or two, whatever you can take with your hands. Put it in your pocket and keep moving. But Lord, look at all this. This is important, Lord. And Lord said, no, no, no. No. Leave it. Just take what you need. Keep moving. Then he said, on the road that I have called you, there are many of these heaps. So you don't need to stop and give up the rest of the roads and the rest of the ways because of a heap of money and gold. You see, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Everything that I have seen, if you talk about physical prosperity, has come from that verse. I was recently listening to Bishop Oyedepo, Winners Chapel. I was amazed to hear him say exactly the same thing. He said his secret of prosperity is seek ye first the kingdom of God and his right. I was amazed. The service to God. Yeah. As you serve God, God will take care of you. Yeah. It's a secret, but it's hidden. When you tell somebody, most of my lay pastors, they didn't believe me. So many of them would have been better off today if they had given themselves up to full-time ministry years ago. Some of them, they regret so much. They want to come to full time. Some of them are afraid they are going to die. Some of them know they are going to die even. Some of them are afraid and some of them know. Yeah. You see, when God calls you, he doesn't change his mind. And that's why I never say no. If somebody says, I want to say, well, why not? I will not say no. Who am I? So ladies and gentlemen, there is a secret, hidden wisdom. And when I say give, it shall be given to you. It's like, how? How give? I know who should give. But he says, you give. So, I mean, how? So it's hidden. Again, it's hidden. Everything is mysterious. God is mysterious. I mean, you even wonder, why doesn't God allow us to go for excursions? I mean, every university allows open day. Why can't we have open day in heaven? We go, we see how it is, and we come back. You get what I'm saying? Open day. We want to see how it's like, what's happening, what are the plans, then we come back and... No, God says no. Be here and have faith. If you don't have faith, Charlie, you just... And when the bell goes, playing, that's it. You go and find out whether it was true or it wasn't true. Once and for all. Yeah. So I want to encourage you all. I don't know. I have not even started what I wanted to preach about. It's true. That's the truth. I've not started preaching, but it's time. You get it? Now listen. The mystery of wealth. Listen. The mystery of wealth is the tithe. Yeah. It's the tithe. It's the tithe. 10%. Is for the Lord. Amen. 10% is for the Lord. But again, it's a very mysterious thing. Because I cannot think of anybody here who gets too much pocket money when you are coming to school. And I cannot tell anybody here who has too much money. Almost everybody I know needs money. Raise your hand if it includes you. Wow. Now, when something is a mystery, a mystery contains decoys and confusing things, which are there intentionally to confuse you. Like if I've hidden something, I don't want you to find it. You create decoys. So when the British Army was going to invade Germany, they made a false airport with false aeroplanes made of balloons. Huge balloons that were tanks. Huge balloons made of cardboard balloons of tanks. The whole tank is a balloon. Aeroplanes, and painted them and packed them so that when the German spy planes come, they see them. So when they saw the planes, huge installation, they knew that the invasion, you know, Hitler was in Europe, but the people who could fight him were Britain. And what separates Britain from Europe is the sea. So you can't drive your cars there. So everything was in England, but not in Europe. Europe was France, next door is Germany. So they have to cross to France, then after that they go to Germany. Do you understand? How to drive all your cars and your soldiers, that is the problem, is the sea. Big sea. So they knew that by almost one day they will invade and come with aeroplanes and ships and all that. So they made a false airport. False harbor, everything false. And painted everything. It was called Operation Fortitude, North and South. Yeah, to deceive them. And it was successful. Hitler did not. The day they told Hitler they are invading from here, he told them it's not true. He didn't believe it. Till they came. It worked. So whenever there is a mystery, there are things that are confusing. So you will see people who pay tithes who don't prosper. You will see people who serve God who die early. You will see people who believe in God who have tragedies. Everything mixed up. Such that you will think that the truth is not true. Oh, yeah. It's true. If it was so clear, once I put in tithe like this, I become a millionaire. Even unbelievers will join falsely to put in their tithe. Because everybody is looking for a get-rich scheme. Quick scheme. If it was a case that all those who take communion unworthily will die. It will be mysterious. So you see that some will take unworthily and will not die. Some will take it worthily and will die. Are you with me?
Yes.
Yeah. So that the whole thing is mysterious. Many, like what the Bible says, do this, you have long life. So honor your father. So you see some people will honor their father and they will still die early. It's all part of the mystery of God. Yeah. But when you look at tithe, that's why we have statistics. Don't confuse us, Mr. Footballer. It's not that you see somebody, the person. Thank you. They're not the person that scored. One, two, no. He scored in this match. Scored this match. He said, no, don't confuse us. We want to look at your play over the last 20 games. Over the last 30 games. See how many times when you pass, it went. How many times when you scored? That's how they know. Because we are going to pay $42 million to have you as our player. You can't confuse us with one or two things. We are going to look at the overall picture of how it is with your play. When I met, what is the name of our striker? Tony Yeboah. Tony Yeboah. Do you know Tony? Is it Tony Yeboah? Yegola. I met him one day on a plane. I met him. I was flying to Ghana. I saw him. I said, so I talked to him. I said, a lot of we're just about to play at that World Cup. So I asked him, can't you play for us? He said, if they will choose. So I asked him, is it true that you are too old? He said, does your game change? He said, honestly, at a certain stage, when you shoot, it doesn't go straight as it used to go before. Yeah. He told me. I was surprised. The footballers. So as they are playing, so what happens? They will look at the number of times you shot at goal and it goes in. That tells us the true picture about you. But if we just look at one or two, we will not see. So if we just look at one or two people paying tithes, we will not see. But if you look at the overall picture of Jews who pay tithes, you will see the richest nation in the world, individuals, what have you. Yeah. When you look at the overall picture, if you look at just one or two, you will never know. That's why it's in science. We don't just look at one thing. You can't tell that Ghana is developed by looking at the road from Tete Kwashi going to Legon. We look at the overall picture, then we see the truth. When you are landing on a plane and you look outside, you will think that Accra has been built in the Sahara Desert because there is no house that has a tar. You see the plane, this is where the planes are landing here. From about 10 minutes in a jet, you are landing like this. And it's fast. I always sit by the window. I'll be looking. The last time I was coming, brown. It is just motorway and Spinters Road that are tarred. The rest is no tar. So that shows you what quality of people have been ruling the country. That if you want to know the truth, not one or two things that we look at. So 58 years of this. You can see that. A lot of the government are not corrupt. I personally don't think they are corrupt. I think that they cannot do it. They can't. I mean, like, it's like you give somebody, he can't do it. It's not that they are thieves, but it's like how to make us prosper. That's the issue. Hey. Are you still here or you are going home? Listen carefully because I'm almost finishing. I'm telling you something. I'm telling you the key. The key of wealth for me has been Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom. But the key of wealth, another key of wealth is the tithe. It is the Lord's. It is the Lord's. It is the Lord's. And it's hidden. Like the cross and the resurrection, it's hidden. Even demons didn't know as they were killing Jesus. Die, 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 sword, everything. Kill him. Oh. Asomwa. He was coming out of the grave. In 3 days, isn't it? 3 days, he was going to rise. And all his enemies would be surprised. Wow.